Hello, welcome to a new showcaser tutorial. Here we have a rural village scenery made for a game. All objects are low poly meshes thought to serve as 3D assets for the game. We want to make an animated presentation of this scenery, like this. Different type of assets are successively dropped on the terrain until the whole scene is complete. Let's open the Layer Manager. You see, we have created one layer for each category of elements: fences, houses, vehicles, and trees. Great, let's open Showcaser. We start by creating a new sequence. Let's name it Dropping Game Assets. Now let's load the objects. Since we want to animate one layer or category of objects at a time, we will use the multiple sets mode to create a set of elements from each layer. We use this button to create new sets from layers. Here we select the desired layers and choose the option one set per layer. On the left, you see the sets, named like the layers, and on the right, the corresponding elements of each set. If you double-click the set, it will select all its objects in the scene. You can use these arrows to move the items up or down in the list to define their order in the animation. Now let's go set by set and use this tool to order the elements from big to small. We can check that they are correctly ordered by double-clicking on the first item in the list and checking which object is selected in the scene. Then we do the same with the last one. Okay, ready. Although here is not necessary, it's a good practice when you have objects that are resting on the floor to set the pivot for animation at the base of the object. Now let's set up the entry animation, which is what we need. I want the elements to move in Z axis. About 250 units. It should be a negative value because I want them to fall to the ground, that is, to move down. Let's build the animation. Since we forgot to set the start and end frames for this animation, the plugin warns us that it cannot animate all of those elements in such a short time. This is because the plugin animates the objects sequentially, one after the other. Therefore, it needs at least one frame per object. But what if we want to showcase a scene with a large number of objects in a few seconds? Well, we have two ways to solve this. The first, and most obvious, is to set a broader time range. But what should be the time range? The animation should have at least the same or more frames than the number of elements to animate. We have 172 elements. So let's set the time range from 5 to 180. That should be enough. Let's see. Indeed, it's enough, but it doesn't look so good. That's because the objects are showing up in only 2 frames. First they are floating and then on the ground. We don't see them falling. So here's the second and the most efficient solution. Using the Animate Objects Together option, which selects groups of elements to animate together, following certain criteria. Let's pick the option by set and see what happens. The plugin is now animating all elements of each layer together, as a group. Now let's see a more interesting use of this function. The option by similar size works amazingly. Let's set a tolerance of 30% similarity. Let's rebuild the animation. Now we're talking. It's much better, and it shows the entire scene fluidly in just 130 frames. Let's make some final adjustments. I'll add some overlapping between animations to make it more dynamic, and set the easing to ease out so they land smoothly. And that's it, the final version. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. See you in the next one.